In the east, there's a mist coming in, like something is brewing and about to begin. Can't put me finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son. The threads of their lives are all raveling undone. Something is needed to twist them as tight as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chimney, chim chim, chari chim chari.
Come on, Jane, let's run!
Come back here, you little blighters! You've got to do your lessons!
I can't do my lessons if I'm flying a kite!
And you can't make us your only aunt, Nanny!
Oh!
Oi, not you two again! Come along home! Oi, come here!
Morning, Miss Lark. And how's little Willoughby today?
Very well, thank you, Bert.
By Jove, is that the beauteous Miss Lark I spy on the horizon?
You and all! Willoughby!
Morning, Admiral. How's it looking?
Dark clouds gathering at number 17. Storm warning's overdue.
Of all London's byways where I doff me cap, this one's the hardest to find on a map. Cherry Tree Lane, as sweet as a song, but the nannies who come here, they don't stay for long. Chim chimney, chim chim, chari chim chari.
Katie Nana! Katie Nana!
Those little beasts have run away from me for the last time.
And who gets stuck with them with no nanny in the house? Me, that's who!
I've said my say, Miss Brill, and that's all I'll say. I've done with this house forever!
Well, good riddance then, and mind you don't stumble on your way out.
Kitty Nana, where are you going? Kitty Nana!
Katie Nana's gone, it isn't any wonder. Driven half demented by your children's pranks.
Do you really think I made another blunder? What on earth am I to say to Mr. Banks? George, dear, I'm feeling so bereft, dear. Another nanny's left, dear. Every nanny goes, we're unlucky, I suppose.
We are never going to find the perfect nanny.
Nonsense! Precision and order, that's all that I ask. The running of a household, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain, whilst I remain the sovereign of Cherry Tree Lane. Coat, the simple truth is you've engaged 6 nannies in the last 4 months, and they've all been unqualified disasters. A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. A nanny is a paragon who suffers no fool. A nanny's a stalwart our children would gain by having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane. So take control of situations. Show your authority when interviewing staff. You know your role, they know their stations. Efficiency and forethought cut the jobs in half. Briefcase!
I thought Katie Nana would be firm with the children. She always looked so cross.
Winifred, never confuse efficiency for a liver complaint. umbrella.
If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid it's not realistic, my dear. Few women alive could handle Miss Andrews' standards of efficiency. Besides, we could never afford someone of her caliber.
Precision and order. He was nothing less. It's like an army barracks.
Yes, and we're in a mess.
No wonder the nannies are driven insane. We're living in a madhouse in Cherry Tree Lane. Oh.
Now, Winifred, if you do want to please me.
You know I do, George.
Very well. Then place an advertisement in the Times stating that Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
We'd better give them ours before they make another mistake.
You must stress
Father!
That.
What's that you're holding, dear?
We've written our own advertisement.
What on earth?
George, I think we should hear it.
Now, Winifred, none of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Wanted a nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, that's debatable, I must say.
George,
if you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and fairly pretty.
Well, of all the ridiculous things.
Take us on outings, give us treats.
Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never feed us castor oil or gruel.
Blech! Love us as a son and daughter.
And never smell a barley water. I put that bit into you.
If you won't scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see.
Put toads in your bed or pepper in your tea.
Hurry, nanny. Many thanks, sincerely. Jane.
And Michael. Banks.
That is quite enough Tommy Rots for one day. Both of you upstairs and let me get to work.
They were only trying to help.
It won't help anyone to make me late. Where's my hat?
Oh. George, dear.
Hat!
Hat!
I thought you put it down here.
Hat!
Hat!
I'm sure a bowler hat helps if we disappear.
Think they'll find a nanny who.
Ah, there it is.
Doesn't run away.
He's crossed it with boot polish.
Precision and order, that's all that I ask. The running of a household, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain.
Whilst I remain the sovereign, mind you use your day well.
You remain the sovereign.
I shall be home at 6 o'clock sharp.
He remains the sovereign of Cherry Tree Lane.
Good morning.
Yes?
I've come in answer to the advertisement.
What advertisement? We haven't placed any advertisement.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
Well, I suppose.
Very well, then. Let's see. Plays games, all sorts, which I most certainly can. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Michael, that's our advertisement.
Rosy cheeks and fairly pretty. There's no objection on that score, I hope.
Oh, no, none at all.
I'm glad to hear it.
Oh, well, take it up with Mrs. Banks. She handles all that side of things. Nothing domestic has got anything to do with me. And don't forget the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought it was usual.
A very old-fashioned idea to my mind. The best people nowadays never acquire them.
I see.
You will have every third Thursday evening off from 5 until 9.
Ah, the best people give every second Wednesday from 6 till 8, ma'am. And that's just what I shall take.
Oh, well, everything's all settled then?
As long as I'm satisfied. I'll see the children now, thank you.
Yes, of course, your time is very nice.
Well,
this is...
Mary Poppins. Jane, don't stare. And Michael, close your mouth. We are not a codfish. Now, best foot forward. Spit spot.
Mrs. Brill, we have a new nanny.
She passed her interview then.
Or I did.
Tidy, I must say. Tidier than I was expecting. Who's responsible for that?
Mrs. Brill. I am. I like to keep things neat.
Do you indeed? Well, I look forward to making use of that. If there's one thing I appreciate, it's a child whose word I can depend on. Now, who's he when he's at home?
That's Valentine. He's mine.
From the look on his face, I'm not sure he'd agree with you.
He's just a doll, and I don't want to play with him right now.
Well, treat him like that, and he won't want to play with you. Now, I always say that the proper place to hang a hat is on a hat stand.
There's nothing in it.
We'd better keep an eye on this one. She's tricky.
Mary Poppins, how could you have known what we wanted in a nanny when we made our list?
Your list? Well, I'm not an item in a weekly shop, thank you very much.
Then how did you get here? It's as if the wind just blew you here.
It did. Now, stand over there. Just as I thought. A noisy, mischievous, troublesome little boy.
You're making that up. A noisy, mischievous...
Now you. Thoughtless, short-tempered, and untidy.
I don't believe you. Let me see.
By the time the wind has blown the weather vane around, I'll show you if I can. No matter what the circumstance, for one thing I'm renowned. My character is spit, spot, spick, and span.
What about your measurement, Mary Poppins?
I'm practically perfect in every way.
Practically perfect.
So people say. Each virtue virtually knows no bound. Each trait is great and patently sound. I'm practically perfect from head to toe. If I had a fault, it would never dare to show. I'm so practically perfect in every way. Lovely. Both prim and proper, and never too stern. Well educated, yet willing to learn. I'm clean and honest, my manner refined, and I wear shoes of the sensible kind. I suffer no nonsense, but whilst I remain, there's nothing else I feel I need explain. I'm practically perfect in every way. Practically perfect, that's my forte. Uncanny nannies are hard to find. The unique yet me conspicuously kind. I'm practically perfect, not slightly soiled, running like an engine that's just been freshly oiled. I'm so practically perfect in every way. Well, those are my credentials. Perhaps you have a few questions.
Not temperamental.
Never.
Not grouchy or gruff.
The very thought.
Will you stay tender when the going gets tough?
Quite the contrary.
Do you read stories without a big fuss?
Mm-hmm.
Or have objections to playing with us?
Oh, I like games, but I choose them.
But that's not fair.
Some minor improvements may not go amiss, but at all times you must remember this.
You're practically perfect in every way.
I guarantee.
Practically perfect. We hope you'll stay.
No flies on me. Each virtue virtually knows no bond. Each trait is great. Take my telescope, thank you.
But that's not fair.
I never said I was fair. I said I was practically perfect, and here's my aim. By the time I leave here, you both will be the same. You'll be practically perfect.
Practically perfect.
You will be practically. Forward, Spitzbot.
Chim-chiminy, chim-chiminy, chim-chim-cheroo. I does what I likes, and I likes what I do. Today, I'm a screever. And as you can see, a screever's an artist of highest degree. And it's all my own work from my own memory.
Oh, Lommy, not these again.
Ah, come on, Mr. Parkkeeper. It's just me pictures like it always is. There's no harm in them.
Oh, be the judge of that. This is my park, and I say you're interfering with a public railing. I want you removed this instant, do you hear me? And that is. Well, just you watch it. That's all. Just you watch it. Get out of my way!
Stay right where you are. I'd know that silhouette anywhere, Mary Poppins.
It's nice to see you, Bert.
Well, I must say, you do look swell.
How does he know you? He can't know you. You've only just arrived.
I wasn't born 1 minute before I walked into your house, Michael Banks. Have you met these two, Bert?
I've seen them running about, chasing a kite.
It isn't a real kite.
So, what are you up to?
Mary Poppins says it's a game. It's called A Walk in the Park.
Ah. Some game. I'd rather eat spinach.
Oh, come on, Bert. You're due for a break. And you promised you'd take me out when we met again. Or have you forgotten?
Of course I ain't, Mary, but...
Oh, dear. Is that all you've got?
I think so.
Never mind. My treat. And no one's charging for the trees in the sky, are they?
Mary Poppins, is he really coming with us?
And why shouldn't he?
Well, he's rather dirty, isn't he? Father would never approve.
What's that?
You can't come with us. You're too dirty. and we don't want to go to the stinky park anyway.
Oh, yes, you do, because when you go walking with Mary Poppins, you go to places you never dreamed of. And if she says it's a game, she's got something in mind. You can be certain of that.
Isn't this a picture of the park?
Mm-hmm.
That's not the park. Not our park. That tree's a much brighter green, and the sky is quite a different blue.
I think you'll find it's just the way I've drawn it. All that it takes is a spark. Then something, plain as a park, becomes a wonderland. All you have to do is look anew, then you'll understand why it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Oh. Mary makes your heart so light.
Oh, really?
When the day is grey and ordinary, Mary makes the sun shine bright.
You do talk nonsense,
all
Bert.
All happiness is blooming all around her. The daffodils are smiling at the dove. When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
You've enough brass for all of us.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. Come on, you two.
Boring, just like other nannies thinking. Parks are good for us. It's just statues, ducks, and grannies. I don't understand all the fuss.
Is she doing this to spite us?
We could lose her for a lark.
Perhaps it's all a plot.
I'll tell you what, she seems so different,
but I bet she's not.
There is nothing to excite us in the park.
What was that?
You're quite wrong, you know.
What? Who are you?
I'm Neelius. Surely you know that. You've sat beneath me often enough. I've waited half a century to take a walk on a sunny day like this.
Ain't it a glorious day? Bright as a morning in May. I feel like I could fly.
Have you ever seen the grass so green? Or a bluer sky?
Bluer sky.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Better days I've never known.
You can ask the passing statuary.
Nothing's ever set in stone.
Good morning, Mary.
Morning, Constable.
You do look tip-top, if I may say so, Mary.
Thank you, Bert. And you may.
Each man out with his dog will stand a call to see a statue take a gentle jog.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary.
No wonder that it's Mary that we love.
It's a jolly holiday with you, Bert. A gentleman like you are few. Though you're just a diamond in the rough, Bert, underneath your blood is
your
blue.
Blood is
you never think of pressing your advantage. Forbearance is the hallmark of your creed. A lady needn't fear when you are near. Your sweet gentility is crystal clear.
It's crystal clear.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with you.
It's a jolly holiday.
A jolly, jolly holiday with you.
Mary!
You've only got yourself to blame, Bert.
a jaunty song tell we are bound to make a mark. Looks like all of us were born to take a promenade in the park.
Hello.
She's an old friend of my father's.
Your father? You're a statue. You can't have a father.
Well, if that's true, then why do I miss him so much?
Isn't your father one of the other statues?
No, he lives far away from here.
Do you really miss him?
Wouldn't you miss your father if you hardly ever saw him?
I'll have to think about that.
That's it! That's it! That's what it was!
What?
The plinth is half empty! The statue's missing!
Do you mean you've lost your marbles?
This is your fault, ain't it? I knew there should be trouble when you first arrived, and now we've got a statue missing! Hmm? What? No, Lummy!
Will you play with us again?
Of course I will. I'm not going anywhere.
Goodbye, Neelius.
Goodbye.
Mary Poppins, Neelius must be so lonely. Could his father ever come to stay with us?
Anything can happen, if you let it.
How long will you stay?
We'll see.
You won't leave us, will you, Mary Poppins?
I'll stay until the wind changes. Now come along.
Good night, Jane. Good night, Michael. Good night, Mary.
Good night, Bert.
Jane and Michael want to say good night.
Tell them you've given me the message.
George, please. Father, we had a fantastic day. We sang with the busker, danced with statues, and we even met Queen Victoria. You wouldn't have approved, but...
If you know that, then why would you do it?
Daddy, could I have a kite? A proper one?
Could you fly it?
You could always teach me.
When would I have time to do that?
Daddy, who was the father of Neelius?
Would you two please let me get on? Good night.
Poor Michael. All he cares about is flying kites. And his beloved astronomy, of course.
I used to love astronomy at his age. My nanny, Miss Andrew, soon beat it out of me.
I suppose we do need a nanny, George. Is it out of the question to do without one?
Don't be absurd. Of course we need a nanny. All the best people have nannies, so the wives can do charity work and entertain. Which reminds me, how is your tea party coming along?
I'm not sure. It seems so odd to send out invitations to people I hardly know.
But they're people you should know. Remember, by your friends shall ye be judged.
But that's the point. They're not my friends. Actually, I heard today from Clemmy Bunting. She was rehearsing a play nearby, and I thought I might ask her.
How many times must I tell you? I wish you to sever all connections with that part of your life.
George, I was an actress. Lots of people might find that interesting. Though you always talk as if I should be ashamed of it.
Well, it's not exactly something to be proud of. Winifred, dearest, I'm only thinking of you. I want people to admire you, respect you.
I know, George, but sometimes it's hard.
It is not hard. It is your job to be Mrs. Banks.
And what is your job?
To pay for everything. What is it?
I was only going to kiss you.
Oh, all right. Are you going to say something to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. Just make sure she's doing things our way and not hers. What good are rules if you can bend them? We need a nanny who is disciplined and stern. With boys and girls, you don't befriend them. I fear that Mary Poppins has a lot to learn.
Being Mrs. Banks should be an easy role, and yet it's one which I don't seem too good at on the whole. I have a comfy home, I have a simple life, I have a name which tells the world I'm someone else's wife. Being Mrs. Banks, what does that entail? Facing tests of character, I always seem to fail. And as for his best people, well, I'd like to say, no thanks. They're not exactly my idea of being Mrs. Banks.
I still feel as if I'm dreaming.
So much fun in just one day.
When Mary holds your end, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
I'm sure Nelias is beaming.
Let's hope she will stay.
Good night, Nelias.
Tides can turn, sink or swim. Say what you learn. Me, I was told when I was small, just learn a trade. So I learned a mole. Chim chim honey, chim chim cherry.
Morning, Bert. Swarming the decks today, I see.
Gotta keep them streets shipshape, Admiral.
How are things aboard number 17? All plain sailing with Mary Poppins, I trust.
There's rough weather on every voyage, Admiral.
Ah, Miss Lark, what those children need is a touch of the cat and a night on the yard.
What those children need, Admiral, is a bit of happiness.
Thank you.
don't make the sandwiches too early. They'll get stale before the guests arrive.
Everything's under control, ma'am.
And what about the cake?
Cooling on the tray, waiting to be iced.
And you're quite sure you know how to ice it?
Quite sure. And in case you're worried, I have not been exchanged by fairies for a total nincompoop.
But no.
No.
Well, I'll just go up and check the drawing room.
I'd like to be helpful.
And I'd like to be rich, but the good Lord thought otherwise.
Mother wants you in the drawing room.
Well, she can't have me. I have enough on my plate as it is.
She says you can tell Robert and I what to do.
Does she indeed? Well, why don't I go have a smoke near the gasworks for good measure?
Please, Mrs. Brill, I don't mind. Honest.
All right, I will give you one task and one task only. And so help me, if you get this one wrong, I'll sing for you and swing as they pull the lever.
Well, what is it, Mrs. Brill?
Put the icing tools next to the cake.
Icing.
And I'll need a bowl of hot water to warm them.
Hot water.
I will make the icing as soon as I'm back.
I will make the icing as soon as I'm back.
Now, do you think you can manage that?
Is that all?
For you, yes. For me, no. Once the cake's done, I have the sandwiches to make because Madame wants them fresh. So I can't start them until there's no time to finish them. I swear, a slave in ancient Rome was on a pleasure cruise compared to my life in this house. All I ever do is work, 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 and no one ever listens to me.
Well, don't just stand there, Robert and I.
Right. Oh, no. Yes.
What are you looking for?
A bowl. For the hot water? Yes.
Michael, what? I have an idea. Why don't we make our own icing?
Because we don't know how.
Don't be so feeble. Go get the eggs. If Miss Brill can do it, it can't be that hard.
Are there eggs in icing?
There are in mine.
I don't think Mrs. Brill will thank you.
Then she will be guilty of great ingratitude.
Is it supposed to look like this?
It doesn't look like that when Mrs. Brill does it.
Don't be impertinent and go get me the cake!
Honestly, Miss Jane, I was only trying to be nice. If you would. Right, so I... Oh! 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 Oh!
Robert and I! Oh dear, should I call a doctor? What have you done?
I don't think that will be necessary, ma'am.
How could you be so unkind when you know how important my party is? You two deserve some very nasty medicine. Just you wait till bedtime.
Why wait until then, ma'am? Now let's go up and get changed. We'll clear up here, won't we?
But we're not ill. I won't take any and you can't make me.
In that, as in so many things, your information is faulty. Open.
It's strawberry ice.
Jane, now
I'm not sure I like strawberry ice.
And I'm not sure I care. Open.
Lime cordial.
Now off we go, you two. Michael, I know you like to keep things neat. Jane?
Can't Robertson I do it when he wakes up? He is a servant.
With that attitude, you'll go through a lot of staff before you're very old. Besides, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun and snap, the job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, the medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
The honeybees that fetch the nectar from the flowers to the comb never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence
they find
their task is not a grind. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
Spitzbot! Cook some sauces? Is this how you usually do it, Michael?
Ma'am, from your guests. They're not coming. None of them.
Do you think we chose the wrong day?
I think you chose the wrong people.
In a most delightful way.
I thought we could play our next game.
What game?
A visit to the bank.
That's not a game. Did Daddy approve?
If he did, you must have put the idea into his head somehow.
What an impertinent thing to say. Me putting ideas into other people's heads. Really?
Position
and it's our job to back them to the hilt. For shrewd investment and advice, they'll pay our price. The bedrock on which banks are built. Banks, a word. I see Herr von Hustler is coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. Be sure it's the right one. We're off!
In every transaction, credit or debt, sheets are all well balanced, targets are met.
Herr Banks, what objections can you have? My security is more than adequate in Latin America's an expanding market.
But, Mr. von Hustler, what I am unable to grasp is, what exactly is your final product?
What do you think? Money, of course.
Yes, money, but making money out of money, is that enough?
Are you man enough to be a banker? A man has dreams of building an empire to make his name in many distant lands. And in the new world, I am told, we'll soon strike gold. Let's seize our chance with both our hands.
Assessing the market, limit the risk. Little room for error, business is brisk. Brisk, 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 brisk.
Have you come to your decision, Mr. Banks? There's a town of good people whose futures depend on you.
Yes, I know that.
Please, Mr. Banks, give us this chance. You won't regret it. We could have the factory up and running in weeks and expanding before the year's out. Please, Mr. Banks, I'd give it everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mr. Northbrook. And I've tried to find a way, but I'm afraid there is just not the collateral.
What about my workforce? Decent men who want a better life. They're my collateral. My men have dreams to earn an honest living. A wife and kids, a home to call their own. If you'd invest in us today, it paves the way. I promise we'd repay the loan.
I'm sorry, Mr. Northbrook, but I'm...
Hello, Daddy.
What are you doing here? Can't you see I'm busy?
No, we're done. And besides, no man should be too busy for his own children. What have you come for, young man? Come for to ask for some money as well?
Hardly. What would they need money for?
Well, it's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. Sixpence.
No, that's its worth. Its value is how you spend it. Do good, and may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you.
I'll wait outside.
What is the meaning of this? Really, Mary Poppins, I'm not without a sense of humor, but...
Aren't you, Daddy?
No, I'm not! But when I was a little boy, I would never have dared interrupt my father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Of course I was. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way, and he would have been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
I shouldn't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Then who kissed you goodnight? Miss Andrew?
Certainly not. There was no time for hugs or kisses or any of that soppy nonsense. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? What do you mean, poor? That's what made me the man I am today, eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes. I'm afraid it did.
Well, you've seen where I work, and I have a great deal to do.
Daddy, when you invest the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man or a good idea?
I suppose I should say it's a good idea, but a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Mr. Von Hustler, I have considered your arguments, but I'm afraid my answer is no.
So you don't recognize a good idea?
Perhaps not. But I do recognize a good man when I see one.
Oh, you will regret this, Sir Banks.
A man with dreams that life hasn't broken. A man with hopes, ambitions to fulfill. A man you're certain at first glance deserves a chance. Now, Mr. Northbrook, when exactly could your factory open?
Thank you, Mr. Banks. You won't regret it.
That horrible old woman.
Don't point. And for your information, she is not in the least horrible.
But she's just a bundle of rags.
When will you learn to look past what you see?
Heavy each day to the steps of St. Paul's, the little old bird woman comes in her own special way. To the people she calls, come by my bags full of crumbs. Come feed the little birds, show them you care, and you'll be glad if you do. The young ones are hungry, their nests are so bare, all it takes is tuppence from you. Feed the birds, tuppence a bag, tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Feed the birds, that's what she cries, while overhead her birds fill the skies.
What are you doing?
I'm going to give her my sixpence.
What a waste.
That's a matter of opinion. Save your sixpence. One bag.
All around the cathedral, the saints and apostles look down as she sells her wares. Although you can't see them, you know they are smiling. Each time someone shows that he cares. Though her words are simple and few, listen, listen, she's calling to you. Feed the birds, tuppence a bag, tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
All gone.
Well, here she is now. You can tell her yourself.
Isn't that Miss Locke's dog, Willoughby?
Don't interrupt when someone's barking. You were saying... Oh, really? Well, if she keeps wandering off like that, perhaps you should keep her on a lead.
Willoughby!
Oh, look.
Here she comes now.
Oh, it's all right. Mummy's here. You know, sometimes I almost think that he can talk.
But can Willoughby really talk?
Of course he can. Getting him to stop is the problem.
How do you learn to talk, dog?
How do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels.
Far too much slang.
Now come along, I can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? What's a silly expression?
There's nothing silly about it in the least.
What do you buy in a talking shop?
Well, conversations, of course.
Well, I've never seen a talking shop.
Well, there is only one, and it belongs to Mrs. Corey.
Who's Mrs. Corey?
Who's Mrs. Corey? Mrs. Corey is older than anyone in the world. She went to William before he went conquering, to Vlad before he went impaling, and to Alexander when he weren't so great.
Now we'll have to call it a shop in the park.
There's no shop in the park.
Anything can happen if you let it.
That's it! I've run out of conversation!
Good day to you, Miss Corey.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mary Poppins with Jane and Michael Banks!
She knows us?
And how is poor little Georgie?
Who?
Georgie Banks, your father. He used to give his nanny the slip and come into my shop here in secret.
But it can't have been the same George Banks. That would have been 40 years ago, and no one can remember back that far.
Listen, dearie, I remember everything. Ooh, I remember Georgie used to love my gingerbread. Ooh, I wonder if we've got any left today. Annie, Fanny, look lively!
Yes, Mother!
There you are. Gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars. Uh-uh. Georgie always saved his stars. Now, Mary Poppins, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversations.
Oh, I'm out of conversations and I'm right out of words too. You see, I've had a lot of chatterboxes in here today. Let me see what we have left. I do have some letters and a little bit of back chat. An ounce, you say?
Yes.
That'll be 15 letters. Go on, take your
Jane,
pick.
You choose 7.
I pick D, G, R, U, C, L, and I.
Michael, 7 more.
A. E. T. O. S. P. And F.
And I'll choose an X. Now, what can we spell?
I see. Dog and cat.
Rataplex, that's 9.
Lapidiferous, that's 11. Nearly there.
Those don't count. You made them up.
And where do you think words came from in the first place? Somebody had to make them up.
You know, we could always use the same letter more than once. Now let's see. Super. Canny. Fragile. Istic, XP, anecdotious.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, it's going to prove a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Super K.
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
It doesn't mean anything. It can mean precisely what you want it to.
When Stone Age men were chatting, simply grunting would suffice.
Though if they'd heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a teeth. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it then, wild animals will not seem so ferocious.
Add some further flourishes, it's sorococococious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Little, 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 little
certain would have used it in their myths.
I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin scholars never had a word like this.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
If you say it softly, the effect can be hypnotious.
Check your breath before you speak in case it's halitosis.
Yuck! Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
You know, you can always say it backwards, which is Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
The cat has got her tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Kick out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well. Then put them in an order, which is very hard to spell.
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F R-A-G-I-L I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D
O-C-I-O-U-S
Smarty pants.
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F R-A-G-I-L I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D O-C-I-O-U-S
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F
R-A-G-I-L
I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D
O-C-I-O-U-S
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F
R-A-G-I-L
I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
S-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-S.
Here we go!
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Don't you sally expletive.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
S-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-S. The winds may blow, but who's to know exactly what it's bringing? Good news or bad, happy or sad, the pendulum keeps swinging.
Right, now put the steps there and stand back. You are never to come near this vase, nor no one else, but me neither. That is an heirloom.
Oh, heirloom.
Yes, and while I do this, stay totally immobile.
Immobile.
Do not move a muscle.
Muscle.
Do not breathe. Do you hear me?
Oh.
Come on.
All right, Mrs. Prill.
Get out.
A game is played, a change is made, but still the road is long. And though they might yet fly a kite, sometimes the wind's too strong.
George, what's happened? Are you ill?
No. Should I be?
Of course not. Only, why on earth are you home so early? Is everything all right?
No. Everything's all wrong.
My dear, what is it?
If you must know. I refuse some German chap alone. It seems he went to our chief rivals. They gave him the money and it's turned into a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud
enough... That is more than loud enough. Go to your room.
But we were just...
I don't care what you were just. Upstairs now. Where's my briefcase? I put it here. Michael, Jane, would you give it to me? Must I put up with this behaviour? You're their mother. Why can't you do something?
Well, I can try not shouting for a start.
Mary Poppins, you are here to teach the children manners. And just look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If it were up to me, you would be out of
George,
this house.
You're tired. Mary Poppins... Don't bring the children down tonight. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted.
I hope you haven't forgotten, ma'am. Tonight's my night out.
Oh dear, I had forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change your plans.
No, ma'am. They wouldn't.
I thought not.
It's not fair. Daddy loses his temper and we're shut up in the nursery. Daddy's mean and rotten and I hate him.
Jane, take that back this instant. I will not have you criticise your father.
Why not? He criticises you. Last week he said you were neither used nor ornament.
How dare you?
I heard him say that, so did you.
Sometimes people say things they don't mean. Take the children upstairs, please, Mary Poppins. George.
What is it now?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
What would be the point?
Perhaps I can help.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'm serious, George. If you have troubles, I'd like to share them.
Don't worry. You will. The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until the bank decides what to do with me.
Twists and turns. Ups and downs. One moment smiles, next moment frowns. But bad-tempered faces better change quick. 'Cause if the wind changes, the face might just stick. Chim-chimony, chim-chim, chorry-chim-choroo.
It's not fair! You're leaving and we get left on our own!
You've plenty of toys to play with!
I don't want to! They're boring.
They might say the same about you.
Why does Daddy get so cross?
Fathers are supposed to look after their children, not yell at them all the time.
Maybe. But have you ever thought about who looks after the fathers when things go wrong?
The mothers, I suppose.
Not the children?
Wouldn't that be rather upside down?
Well, sometimes families are upside down. For a while, anyways.
I don't want to be part of an upside down family. I wish I could just run away.
Why don't you? Somebody might adopt you.
But you'd miss me.
No, I wouldn't. I could have your toys.
No, you could not give me that. Now look what you've done.
That's no way to treat Valentine. What's he ever done to you?
He's a doll, silly. He couldn't do anything.
That's all you two. Now into bed at once.
But we haven't had our milk.
There will be no milk and no butts either. If you can't be good, you may as well be sorry. Oh, poor Valentine. Go inside and make yourself presentable.
I wish you'd just leave us alone.
Be careful the things you wish for.
Well, I won't go to sleep and you can't make me.
In that, as in so many things,
your information
is faulty. Playing the game, taking your turn. Some children lose, some children learn. Treat the toys nicely and maybe they'll treat you the same. Playing the game. Feeling any better, Valentine?
Much better, thank you.
Tempers are frayed, tempers are lost. Nobody stops to think of the cost.
But they tore my arm again.
Oh dear, children who lose their temper will lose everything else in the end.
They're not playing the game, not playing fair. Not with the doll, not with the bear.
Thrown on the floor and neglected, and they were to blame.
Playing the game. Please tell them, Mary Poppins.
Why don't you?
What's going on? What's happened to the toys?
Make them go small and get back in their box.
Why should I? You've hurt them and called them names. And now, it's their turn. Summon the toys. Now is the time to tell of your woes, to tell of their crimes.
Crimes! Crime!
Come on, come on. Enter the fray. They need to hear what you have to say.
Will we meet?
Bert?
And stars is the chimney sweep's world, where there's hardly no day, nor hardly no night. There's things half in shadow and halfways in light. On the rooftops of London.
Ooh.
What a sight.
So you're asleep now, are you?
Best view in the world, eh? And who gets to see it? The birds, the stars, and the chimney sweeps. Nothing to beat it, eh? Now, as the ladder of life has been strung, you may think of sweeps on the bottom most rung. Though I spends me time in the ashes and smoke, in this whole wide world, there's no happier bloke. Chim chimony, chim chimony, chim chim cheree. A sweep is as lucky can be. Chim chimony, chim chimony, chim chim cheree.
Good luck will rub off when he shakes hands with you.
Or blow me a kiss.
Bert!
And that's lucky too. Are you going then?
The wind has changed.
But they're good kids, Mary.
Oh, would I be bothering with them if they weren't? But there's no one so hard to teach as the child who knows everything.
So?
So they've got to do this next bit on their own.
Chim chimony, chim chimony, chim chim cheree. When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company.
Goodbye, Bert.
Chim, chim, chim chim cheree. When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company. Nowhere is there a more happier crew than them's what sings chim chim, chari chim charu. Chim chimony, chim chim, chari chim.
Cheerio, Bert. Keep an eye on them for me.
Oh, yes, she can. And she's taken all our toys.
What does the note say?
What in the name of heaven are you two doing out here? Where's Mary Poppins?
Gone.
Gone? Well, if that doesn't take the bloomin' biscuit.
Mrs. Brill, what does au revoir mean?
Why?
Because that's what she's written in the note. Dear Jane and Michael, keep playing the games. Au revoir. Mary Poppins.
Well, it's French, I know that. Does it mean good luck?
No.
God bless you?
No.
Till we meet again. Now please come inside before you catch your death.
is the nursery tidy?
As tidy as I can make it, ma'am.
If only you knew how hard it was to track her down.
Really, ma'am? Fancy that.
Call to get for the nannies who are flipping past time. Now when one returns, they make a fearful fuss. Never liked her much when she was here the last time.
At least she makes life easier for the both of us.
Mrs. Brill, it is her, isn't it?
Well, I don't know who else.
Why is it such a secret?
Do you think that she's returned to get things back the way they were?
The note says, till we meet again.
I just know it must be her.
Oh my goodness, she'll be here any moment. And now where is George? George, dear, you're going to be surprised.
Winifred, you know I hate surprises at the best of times.
Oh, not this one. I do believe you're going to be proud of me for once. Precision and order. It's perfectly true. Can really make a difference. I found her for you. Clear thinking, sound judgment. And now we'll regain a home you can be proud of in Cherry Tree Lane. Hurry up, everyone, into the hall. I want her to find everything spick, spot, spick and span.
Spick and span.
Our sense of excitement is hard to contain.
Order is returning.
Wonder is returning.
Someone is returning.
Enjoy travel. You must be poor George's wife. Your flower beds are disgracefully untidy. Take my advice. Plant evergreens. Or better yet, have nothing there at all. Oh, just a plain cement courtyard.
Miss Andrew, I'm so fond of flowers.
Then you are a very silly woman. Where did George go?
He must have had an urgent appointment.
For which no doubt he was late as usual. It's not much of a house, is it?
We like it.
Then it doesn't take a lot to keep you happy. Look at the dust. There. There.
Phil! We are rather short-staffed at the moment.
Hasn't anyone ever cleaned those curtains?
Oh, wait just a minute!
You must be the children. Pity! I don't suppose you know who I am.
Yes, we do. You're the Holy Terror.
Impudent boy! You're Jane, I suppose. Why aren't you wearing stockings?
I don't like them.
Tut! What manners! I can see there is not a minute to lose. These children have been spoiled. I've arrived here just in time. By chance, I brought the punishment that best befits the crime. Brimstone and treacle and cod liver oil, liberal doses of each. These are the traits from which children recoil, the lessons I'm going to teach. Just follow my model and don't mollycoddle, it may lead the irksome to irk. So seek satisfaction from punitive of action. Brimstone and treacle will work. Open!
Oh, does it taste as bad as it smells?
Worse!
Do I have to?
Open brimstone and treacle and carbolic soap. These are the tools of my trade. With spoonfuls of sugar, you'll seeing that changes are made. Where manners are chronic, my tincture's the tonic that's certain to wipe off a smirk. Just pour out a ration in matronly fashion. Brimstone and treacle will work. Your son will go to boarding school at once. As for the girl, I shall take charge of her myself. I won't stand for whining or whinging or whimpering, crying or lying or sobbing or simpering. I mean it's clear that in these two such bad habits lurk. First threaten to throttle, then uncork the bottle. Brimstone and treacle will work. Now show me my room. Brimstone and treacle.
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but I'm disappointed, truly I am. I really thought it was going to be, you know, with the umbrella.
Yes.
What are we going to do?
The only thing we can do, run away.
Easy now, your old friend ain't going to hurt
you. Oh, Bert, it's you.
You're filthy.
Perhaps a smudge or two. It so happens today I'm a chimney sweep. So, what's the matter?
And who's after you?
The nastiest nanny in the world.
Oh, the nastiest nanny in the world, eh? Well, you two should know you've been through enough of them. Is she really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young.
Miss Andrew was Daddy's nanny.
Which explains a lot.
Poor Daddy. Ever since he stopped working, he just sits and mopes. Mary Poppins used to say he needed our help, but now it's too late.
Now, why wouldn't say that? Tell you what. Why don't we start things off with a bit of a shake for good luck?
Why would shaking hands with you bring us luck?
Didn't anyone ever tell you it's lucky to shake a sweep's hand?
But what do you do if you need some luck?
Oh. Well, I shake hands with myself. Now. What have we got here?
Michael, look! It's a real one! What's the matter? You've always wanted to fly a proper kite.
I always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have. But you need to learn how it's done first. Get some training in, and you'll make him the proudest father in the country.
You really think so? You're not just saying that?
Did I say the country? The whole blooming empire, more like. With tuppence for paper and strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly a kite.
Try again.
Try again.
What's this? What's this? We don't allow litter here.
It's not litter, it's a kite.
Oh, a kite, is it? Yeah, get out of my pot.
My word, it is a kite. I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy.
Well, let's wind her up, give her a run, and away she'll fly!
I want to do it.
Oh. But you'll let me help, won't you? Seeing as I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy.
Oh, all right.
When you send it flying up there, all at once you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees with your fist held in tight to the string of your kite.
Oh, let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring.
You can do it! Just pull one more time!
Life's a tragedy. Now come along.
But she's there. She came this morning as a surprise for Daddy.
Did she indeed? Well, perhaps I'll be a surprise for her. That was a lovely greeting, Bert.
I meant it, Mary. Welcome. You're a sight for sore eyes.
You really are. Welcome back, Mary Poppins.
I told you they were good kids, Mary.
And I told you they were worth bothering with.
Now see here, it's against the regulations. Coming down from the sky like that? Oh. And where from? That's what I'd like to know, eh? Where from?
If I were a park keeper, I should fix my tie and straighten my cap.
What? No, not me!
Aren't you going to shake hands with Bert for luck?
No.
Why not? We did.
I don't need any luck, thank you.
Thank you.
illusions may shatter, but memory stay. The things that really matter I lost on the way. The sovereign, the master, and long may he reign. The famous good for nothing of Cherry Tree Lane.
They'll find their way home in no time.
Let's face it, they've had enough practice.
But this time they're not being naughty. I'm afraid I've made them unhappy. I'm afraid I've made everyone unhappy.
They'll turn up. Don't you worry.
George, dear, I know it hurts your pride, dear. But you can't just run and hide, dear. Why can't you see that I am here? And I am on your side. Whenever you spoke of Miss Andrew, you showered the woman with praise. But now that I've met dear Miss Andrew, there are one or two things I'd rephrase. To think you were raised by that monster and carried that burden through life. If only you had seen that you could share it with your wife. Being Mrs. Banks, it's easy to forget the way I felt that summer's day, the day that we first met. Being Mrs. Banks, being kissed by you, a man of dreams who made me feel that wishes do come true. And now, although you're lost, it's time that we close ranks. I'll fight for the man who needs freeing, the real you no one is seeing.
Well, frankly, that's not a surprise. Locked in this cage, not free in the skies. For 2 years, how shameful. Yes, of course, that's a field I know well. An hour no longer, your wings will grow stronger. Once you are free from this cell.
What kind of bird is it?
It's a lark. You are seeing a lark in its cage for the first time. And the last. My pleasure. Don't mention it.
I am going downstairs to fetch Caruso, my lark. You stay there and clean the grate again. little children, you've decided to come crawling back, have you? Well, I guess we know what's needed now. I'll give it to your devil children. Brimstone and treacle, my favorite liquor, that will make runaway stubble. Impudent children respond so much quicker when forced to drink every last drop.
Is this what you're looking for?
Who are you?
I'm Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins? But you left without notice.
And now I've come back without notice.
I see. And what do you expect me to do?
Pack.
Pack? Insolent young person, how dare you speak to me this way? Silly little girl with your newfangled methods. I bring up children so they know their place. Standing for tradition, I govern my charges.
Mishandled charges blow up in your face.
I brought up their father.
Well, that I don't doubt. You must be so proud of the way he turned out.
A shining example, a pillar.
A post. They all have their problems, but him more than most.
Caruso! Where is my lark? Caruso! You let my little lark out of his cage. Now you will bear the full brunt of my rage! Brimstone and treacle for you. Brimstone and treacle.
Just
for
a spoonful
you.
Of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle.
Just
for
a spoonful
you.
Of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle.
Just a
spoonful
for you. Of sugar. As long as necessary, ma'am.
Because the last time you were here, you left without a word of warning. How am I to know you won't do it again?
You don't.
Oh.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Constable, I'm so sorry I bothered you, but it's quite all right. They're back
Not
and safe.
Not all of them, ma'am.
What?
We found this one wandering in the park. Good night, ma'am.
George.
Where is she?
Miss Andrew, she left.
Left? But how?
She might have thought we were rude.
Rude? To Miss Andrew? Well, I can't forgive it, but I'll certainly try to forget. In fact, I'd give you sixpence if I had it.
George, you haven't noticed. Mary Poppins is back.
Is she? Well, Mary Poppins, might I have a word?
Yes.
Well, there's no point in beating about the bush. Things have not gone well for us since you left, and I'm afraid...
About my wages, sir. If you don't mind, I won't accept any just now. I would like to let them accrue.
But Mary Poppins, if you only knew how many were accruing as it is.
Is everything all settled?
It is. Now I must get started. Jane, Michael, Spitspot. Are the drains playing up or is Mrs. Brill cooking? Oh, dear.
Come along, darling. You made one wrong decision, but how bad is that? After so many years of good service, what's the worst that can happen?
Winifred, if I am to be dismissed by the bank, we'll be destitute. The servants will leave, the house will be repossessed, we'll be out with the children, sitting on the frosty curbside.
But we'll still have what really matters. The children and each other.
You're practically perfect in every way.
I guarantee.
Practically perfect. We hope you'll stay.
Let's wait and see. Uncanny nannies are hard to find.
Unique yet meek.
Unspeakably kind.
You're practically perfect.
And yet I'm sure there's still room for improvement. A few games more.
Is that what we need?
And so if it is.
What's inside it?
A portrait.
Whose?
You'll know when the time comes and not before.
You won't leave us again, will you, Mary Poppins?
I'll stay until the chain breaks.
What chain?
Where?
Michael, you must be careful. The room's a bit excited to see me back. And you never know what might happen around a fireplace.
Whoa, Mary Poppins, help! Mary
Michael,
Poppins!
Michael, come back! Come back!
Hello there.
Bert, what are you doing up here?
And where else might a chimney sweep be? A chimney swept, a secret kept, up here above the gables. Another world to be unfurled, it ain't just myths and fables. A chimney stack looks cold and black against a twilight sky. But never fear, there's warmth up here. Perhaps you'll find out why.
What do I look like? That's better.
The world is awfully big, isn't it?
And what does that tell you?
That we are awfully small and unimportant?
Speak for yourself!
Not us so much, but our problems. They seem so big in the nursery, but up here...
That's more like it. Troubles are never as bad as they seem when you look at them from a little higher up. And remember, there's plenty of folk ready to help you should you need it.
Who?
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cherie. Now guardian angels you don't often see. They're not highfalutin, not grand nor aloof. Nah, they're covered in soot, and they're up on your roof.
Chim chimini, chim chim chiree.
See? It's true.
Brush away the dirt and soot.
Brush away your tears.
Cobwebs that are swept away hang around for years.
In all weathers of all us, we can see for us our idea of heaven is night out on the top.
step in.
Step in time.
We will step in.
Step in time.
Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. We will step in.
Step in time. Over the rooftop, step in time. Over the rooftop, step in time. Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. Over the rooftop, step in time. Watch your step, but step in time. Watch your step, but step in time. Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. Watch your step, but step in time. Pick your knees up, step in time. Pick your knees up, step in time. Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. Kick your knees up, step in time.
Childhood is a step in time. Parenthood's the same. Never miss a chance to get it wrong.
Don't it seem a shame when the steps aren't going as smoothly as they might? Hey, look at her go!
That's what we step in, step in time. That's what we step, step in time. Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. That's what we step in, step in time.
Here we go!
Step in time. Give me the step in time.
Dragon Tank! What's it gonna do?
Step in time!
Shout it louder!
Step in time! Never need a reason, never need a run. Down the chimney, step in time. Back to the nursery, step in time. Back to the nursery, step in time. Never need a reason, never need a run. Back to the nursery, step in time.
Special delivery for George Banks Esquire.
Special delivery?
Special delivery, step in time. Special delivery, step in time. Never need a reason, never need a run. Special delivery, step in time.
Good night, Governor.
Good night, Governor, step in time. Good night, Governor, step in time. Good night, Governor, step in time.
And say
good night, Governor.
Back to the roof, Pops. Let's go now. Come on. Very good. Back to the roof, Pops. Let's go. Cheerio.
Cheerio, Governor.
Not so fast. Upstairs now. Jane, you too. Mary Poppins, would you care to explain?
First of all, I would like to make one thing very clear.
Yes?
I never explain anything. Come along, children.
It's happened. The chairman wants to see me at the close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and jolly well give your chairman a piece of my mind.
That would only make matters worse. We might as well face it. In just a few hours, I will have joined the ranks of the unemployed.
Oh, George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. So we'd better start making some plans. In fact, I'm afraid the time has come.
Do you mean your mother's vase? Won't she miss it terribly?
Needs must, my dear. We always said we were saving it for a rainy day. And tomorrow it looks set to pour.
Oh, George, do be careful. Mrs. Brill! Let's go to the kitchen, shall we? You'd better sit down.
Mrs. Brill, is that the dinner cooking?
Don't you start! I've opened up all the windows!
I was only going to say that it smells delicious!
The whole world has gone upside down!
Well, I never. So that's where I put them.
What are they?
Stars. Gingerbread stars I hid once from my nanny. I always knew I'd put them somewhere no one would find them. Trouble was, I couldn't find them either.
They're very bright.
Aren't they? Even after all this time.
Here, let me give you a hand.
I used to dream that when I got older, I'd learn everything there was to know about the stars. Funny, I haven't thought about that in all these years. I'm not usually sentimental.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? I'm not so sure.
A man has dreams of walking with giants to carve his niche in the edifice of time. Before the mortar of his ill has the chance to congeal. The cup is dashed from his lips. The flame is snuffed a-borning. He's brought to rack and ruin in his prime.
Life's a rum go, Governor. And that's the truth.
You know what I think? It's Mary Poppins. From the moment she stepped into this house, things began to happen to me.
My world was calm, well-ordered, exemplary. Then came this person with chaos in her wake. And now my life's ambitions go with one fell blow.
It's quite a bitter pill to take. It's that Poppins woman. She's responsible for all of this.
I know the very person. What's that thing she's always saying? A spoonful of sugar, that is all it takes. It turns bread and water into tea and cakes. A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. So have yourself a healthy helping every day.
A healthy helping of trouble, if you asked me.
Like you say, Governor, you've got to grind, grind, grind at that grindstone. Though childhood slips like sand through a sieve, and all too soon they've up and grown, and then they've flown. And it's too late for you to give just that spoonful of sugar to help the medicine go down. The medicine go down. Medicine go down.
Well, good luck, Governor.
Thank you, Bert, and good luck to you too.
Father!
What is it?
We've come to say goodnight.
Ah, yes. Good night.
Do you remember when we came to the bank?
Yes.
Well, we were each given sixpence and we were told to spend them wisely.
Excellent advice. It's exactly what you should do. What did you buy with them?
Nothing yet. We saved them and now we've decided to give them to you.
I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this.
Oh, she hasn't said a word about it. But we know things have been hard for you lately and we haven't exactly been of much help.
So we thought a bit of extra cash might loosen things up a little.
It's a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know.
Jane, do you remember when you asked me who Neelius's father was?
Yes.
It was Poseidon, king of the sea. Good night.
Worried, isn't he?
Yes, he is, but you must remember that he loves you very much, and that's far more important than jobs or houses or anything else.
Are you going to the bank with him?
No. I wish he'd let me, but he wouldn't. If only there was someone there to speak up for him, to take his part, to show them what he's really like inside.
Why can't you do that for himself?
Because he's a man, and a very proud one.
Then you must go.
I'm afraid it just isn't possible.
Why?
Because I'm a woman.
Mary Poppins says that anything is possible if we can only get out of our own way.
Do you really believe that, Mary Poppins?
Anything can happen if you let it. Sometimes things are difficult, but you can bet it doesn't have to be so.
Changes can be made.
You can move a mountain if you use a larger spade.
Anything can happen, it's a marvel.
You can be a butterfly,
or just stay larval. Stretch your mind beyond fantastic. Dreams are made of strong elastic.
Take some sound advice and don't forget it. Anything can happen if you let it.
I wonder. Anything can happen if you let it. You won't know a challenge until you've met it.
No one does it for you.
No one but yourself. Vacillating violets get left upon the shelf. Anything can happen, just imagine.
That should be my epitaph. I wear the badge in honor of this world's free thinkers.
Those who see beyond their blinkers.
Jelly isn't jelly till you set it.
Anything can happen if you let it. If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we've found a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars thrown in.
Feed the birds, tuppence a bag. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Feed the birds, sir, only tuppence a bag.
I would take it as a great favour if you kindly fed them for me.
Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Precision and order, paying one's debts, risking our investments, hedging our bets.
Sir, Mr. Banks is here.
Come in, Banks.
Trading in futures, sharps on the line.
Well, Banks, how did it happen? You turned down a scheme that was bound to make millions, and we want to know why.
Then I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because his scheme was hollow. It had no product. It had no substance. It had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Yes, he told me about the profits and the assets and the growth, but there wasn't a word about people. Now I know as far as you're concerned, if any man puts value on real life, then he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I will not apologize for realizing that there are more important things in life than making money.
Ruining the bank? Ruining the bank? Ruining the bank? My dear chap, what are you talking about? You've saved our bacon. Haven't you heard? Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You've kept us out of the nastiest scandal since records began. We don't want your apologies. We're offering ours.
Oh, my word.
And another thing. Do you remember giving a loan to a fellow called Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it and opening two new factories. With the percentage you negotiated, we look set to make a fortune.
Oh, my word.
That's just it. We very much hope you might tell us how you did it. Just give us the word. It'll be quite safe with us.
Give you the word? Give you the word? I'll give you the word. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Thank you, sir.
Now, Bank.
If it's not his fault, it's all because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The Holy Terror, she taught me everything I know.
And now's your chance to forget it.
That's right. And if you want to fight about it, you've come to the right woman.
Darling, it's all right, darling. I haven't lost the bank money at all. I've made the bank a fortune.
Really?
Gentlemen, madam, if you please, we still have some business to conduct. Ah. Well, Banks, George, by way of recompense, we'd like to offer you the job of senior manager with a salary at double.
Exactly how much has he made for you?
Triple? Quadruple your present rate.
George, close your mouth. We are not a codfish.
Well,
I accept. But you must understand one thing. From now on, my family comes first.
Agreed?
Agreed.
Winifred, it seems I've underestimated you. How can you forgive me?
How can you ask?
It was wrong of me to keep you from the stage. You'll want to return, and I won't mind if you do.
No. I loved it, but I found a role I much rather prefer. And it's going to keep me extremely busy for a very long time.
Anything can happen, raise the curtain. Things you thought impossible will soon seem certain. Though at first it may sound clownish, see the world more upside downish. Turn it on its head, then pirouette it.
Anything can happen if you let it.
If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we've found a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars thrown in.
No wonder you don't want the moon as well.
Neely isn't
Poseidon will live happily ever after, won't they?
Of course.
Oh, Mary Poppins, that was the best yet. To be up in the heavens. Do you think we'll ever go back there?
Someday.
Really? Will it be soon?
No, not for a very long time. But you can keep an eye on the stars until you return. Here.
But it's your telescope.
So it is. Take it if you like. It's a present.
Thank you.
Now run along in, it's getting cold.
I love you, Mary Poppins.
You are a fine boy, Michael Banks. And one day, you'll be a fine man.
Oh, Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk like that.
Like what?
All gentle and kind, and not a bit like yourself. Be cross, Mary Poppins. Do be cross again.
Is this the thanks I get for all the trouble I've taken?
That's better.
Oh, that dainty bird.
They're yours, Mary. I painted them for you. It's tonight, isn't it?
It is.
Well, goodbye, Mary.
Goodbye, Bert. Look after yourself. Job when it's complete, there is a sense of bittersweet. That moment when you know the task is done, and though you know you'd like to stay and help things on their way, you've always known they must do it. Practically perfect. And let's hope it remains so.
What's happened? Something's changed.
There's Mary Poppins' locket.
Oh, the chain's broken.
Don't you remember? I'll stay till the chain breaks.
There's a note too. It says, Michael had the telescope, so this is for you. It's a picture of the three of us.
Look, she signed it. From Mary Poppins, with a good deal of love.
Mary Poppins?
She's gone.
Gone?
She'll be back. Now, what do you think of this?
It's the best I've seen.
Could we fly it together?
Oh, Daddy.
Mary Poppins isn't coming back.
My dear, how could you know such a thing?
Because we don't need her. Not anymore. And other families will, won't they, Daddy?
They will.
What if she's right, George? And we don't need a nanny anymore. What do you think?
I think you'd better come dance with me.
George, this is serious.
Look, wasn't that a shooting star?
You can borrow my telescope.
I was right. Wish on it, children. My dearest love.
We won't won't forget you, Mary Poppins.
We'll never forget.
Then you'll understand.
Why, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary makes your heart so light.
Oh, really?
When the day is grey and ordinary, Mary makes the sun shine bright.
You do talk nonsense, Bert.
All happiness is blooming all around us. The daffodils are smiling at the dove. When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Oh, your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
You've enough brass for all of us.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. Come on, you two.
Boring, just like other nannies thinking. Parks are good for us. It's just statues, ducks, and grannies. I don't understand all the fuss. Is she doing it to spite us?
We could lose her for a lot.
Perhaps it's all a plot.
I'll tell you what, she seems so different.
But I bet she's not. There is nothing to excite us in. What was that?
You're quite wrong, you know.
What? Who are you?
I'm Neelius. Surely you know that. You sat beneath me often enough. I've waited half a century to take a walk on a sunny day like this.
Ain't it a glorious day? Right to the morning in May, I feel like I could fly.
Have you ever seen the grass so green or a bluer sky?
Bluer sky!
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Better days I've never known.
You can ask the passing statuary. Nothing's ever set in stone.
Morning, Mary.
Morning, Constable.
You do look tip-top, if I may say so, Mary.
Thank you, Bert. And you may.
Each man out with his dog will stand a dog to see a statue take a gentle jog.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary.
No wonder that it's Mary that we love.
It's a jolly holiday with you, Bert. Gentlemen like you are few. Though you're just a diamond in the rough, Bert, underneath your blood is blue. You never think of pressing your advantage. Forbearance is the hallmark of your creed. A lady needn't fear when you are near. Your sweet gentility is crystal clear.
It's crystal clear.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with
it's
you,
a jolly holiday, a jolly, jolly holiday with you.
Mary! Mary!
You've only got yourself to blame, Bert.
Let's go for a jaunty sauntery. Bound to make a mark. Looks like all of us were born to take a promenade in the park.
Hello!
Happiness is coming all around you. smiling at the door.
Look down from above.
When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band. Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary.